Welcome back. This is episode 61, and for those of you who skipped the last two episodes, I'd like to introduce you to Dagna, who is our...
Serve the Lord who loaded his catapults with anvils. Point made.
All right. Our new, Archivist, who does our masterwork stuff. Not going to get into those because they're crafting things, so if you're not interested in crafting, then don't worry about them. But I do want to talk to Dagna, because I didn't want to talk to her in the last episode, since some people may have skipped them. But
how are you?
All right. If you don't remember Dagna, she was the dwarf in Origins, who we sent to the Chantry because she wanted to be a mage, but instead she became a studier of arcane materials.
Where does a dwarf go to study magical theory?
Get out. I asked myself that question for years. Turns out, not in Orzammar. I had to start at a circle. I had help, though. A Grey Warden, and I am forever grateful. With that sanction, I visited a half dozen circles. The wonders I've seen. And with an objective eye, I can spot where they overlap. That's a surprise for every teacher. It's a grand tradition, and it works so well with new thinking.
I can definitely see Dagna being a good at what she does.
You mentioned a Grey Warden who helped you start your studies.
Not any Grey Warden, the Grey Warden. The Hero of Ferelden is a hero in Orzammar, too. It's incredible that someone like the Hero of Ferelden would stop to help the little people. Literally.
Well, he kind of had to, because he needed your help to fight the Darkspawn, but I'd like to think he would have done so anyway. And we might be actually meeting the Warden if what I hope to be true is true, but it's also quite possible that we're just going to meet Stroud, so we'll see.
You gave up so much, left your home. Was it really that amazing?
Yes. I left my home and my family, but I knew... I just knew I could be more than a smith. I wish my people weren't stuck in the past, and I regret that my father couldn't imagine another life for me. But I don't regret what I did.
Your years of study have paid off.
Oh yes, the mages said I brought a valuable perspective. I've even presented my work to the College of Enchanters. I wanted an exchange. The surface could learn about lyrium smithing, and Orzammar would gain knowledge of magic. But now there's no college. And so far as the Shaperd is concerned, I'm castless. So you're getting my best work, Inquisitor. Let's make some great stuff.
That is the plan.
The Warden affected you in a special way.
Talk to anyone, they'll say the same. It was a dark time. There was one light. He saved us. He saved me.
He had a little help, and some of that very same help is here in Skyhold, so hopefully it'll be enough.
All right, rein it in. You have work to do.
Right, sorry. I get carried away when I think of it. Ready when you need me.
All right, so we'll keep an eye out for other masterwork ingredients to bring to her. What is this? Oh, do we have new upgrades? Sort of... What is that? Is that an item or a recipe? I guess... Oh, there we go. It is a unique sword, level 7, so not that great. And we probably will not end up using it. Let's see. She currently has 138, so no. We'll stick with what I have, but... Must be some DLC items that are taking their time somehow. As you saw, I didn't have new armor for the character, even though I like the other armor better. This one has better stats, so we're going with it for now. Alright, so first things first, let's go not to there, not to there. Grr. That is where I did not want to go. To the war table. I feel bad for always making these three come in here to talk to me. Like, I could probably handle this on my own, guys, if you want to stay with what you're doing. Alright, so we did have all three of my advisors return. There's some influence. Not great, but it's something. We may have gotten more if we had a different
anything?
Advisor.
Not yet. I'll let you know as soon as I do.
Work on the report is underway. Alright, so I guess it'll be a while before it's complete. And we have an amulet of power. That could be useful, perhaps. Alright, so... Harden Hightown, Trouble in Skyhold. Harden Hightown 3, another unsolicited sequel. Killer and author are clearly linked. So... Liliana could look into it. Let's let her continue what she's doing.
Inquisitor.
And what else do we have? Did that. Dementor resistance. Dorian. Alright.
At your service.
Dwarven slaves. Okay. So must be surface dwarves. Possibly from Tevinter. Alright, Cullen. Go for it.
Alright.
We, meanwhile, are going to probably do the western approach. Let's see what our other choices are. Yep, let's do that. A blighted desert with no trade routes. And no one is leaving. Oh, excuse me. Alright. So we have a foothold there. Report accepted. Yep, let's go. I might use the same party as last time, so we didn't get to use them very much. We fought a dragon, but it didn't really go so well, so let's keep these three for the time being. Confirm. And we get to explore a whole new area. This should be exciting. Oh, I see, it's like a hawk. What is that thing? It looks kind of creepy, like a tree with claws. It's supposed to be a hawk, I think.
Inquisitor, welcome to the Western Approach. You're a long way from the Winter Palace now.
I guess I'm dressed for the
Between
warm weather.
Between the sandstorms and the vicious wildlife, we haven't made it far out here. One of my men got too close to a poison hot spring and gave me a slightly delirious report of a high dragon flying overhead. In short, this might just be the worst place in the entire world. Be careful out there.
A high dragon, you say?
Well, it's good to know what I'm in for.
Sorry, I don't have more for you. We intercepted a Venatori messenger and, persuaded him to give up the orders he was carrying. We have them here. This entire place. It just feels like something's not right. Be careful.
So this is kind of like the Forbidden Oasis, which makes sense because it's pretty close by.
Inquisitor, I've something for you.
Sure.
What is it?
This could help us.
And we should get our potions restocked up. Wildly steady. So four camps here, that gives us a general idea of the, area size. Excavating and summoning attempts. White Claw Associates. So they're definitely doing something magical and interesting in this area. Okay, so as much as I hate using up my precious elf root, we're going to need to. Alright, Cecily Avara, Cassandra. Wait, Cassandra? Well, I guess we'll get her supplies back up as well, even though she's not here. Sarah could use poison, and what else do I give to my rogues? I'm going to give them, even if I had something different before, regeneration potion, because when you're fighting like a high dragon, it's good to have some health restoration, even if it's only gradual. And we can always upgrade that as we go. Dorian. Hope they don't run out of elf root again. Blackwell is still good. Cole has nothing. Vivian. Ah. Merrick is fine with his Blood Lotus. Who is this? Iron Bull could definitely use these. Right, four more elf fruit. Not a lot. I think Solus or Cole had like nothing, so let's give him these first. That's Blood Lotus, that's okay. And is there anybody else? Who's this? Vivian? Alright, let's give her two of these. And we'll give Cole two of those. Wonder if he'll use the Jar of Bees on his own if I tell him to. Or any of these grenades for that matter. Alright, well, we'll go with that for now. Alright, so let's see. We can go north, we can go south. It's kind of a diamond-shaped area. Primeval lyrium veins. Alright, well, Beric is not with us, but I guess we could close those anyway. There's a rift not far from here. Let's start with that rift, then. As you can see, everybody has their shiny new outfits. Looking nice. Usually I try to put my female characters in a little more practical outfits than this, but this just happened to be the one that had the best stats in it by quite a bit, so. And it makes sense, we're in the desert, so she wouldn't want to wear anything too heavy, I guess. Poor Iron Bull is probably... And Dorian, for that matter, too. Is that Dorian? That's Solus. That's Solus. I imagine it's quite hot in all those layers. And we cleared out our inventory. Did we clear out inventory? Well, not really. Okay. So, note to self, keep an eye out for a merchant, because we did have our inventory cleared, and then we did that last mission on the, with the Red Lyrium Templars. And, yeah, now we're all out of elf fruit. Aw. Death root. I imagine there's not too much elf fruit around here. There's a logging stand, but what we need is a quarry. We have tons of logging stands. So that's the world map location up there, right? Okay. So we can head north, I guess. But yes, keep an eye out for merchants. Those statues look a lot like the ones in Kirkwall. And there's that rift. So this area is a lot like, ooh, what's this? Paragon's Luster. It's a tier 2, I think. Probably be a while before we find tier 3 stuff. I think we're solidly in the tier 2 range in most of these zones. A couple rare tier 3 things here and there, but we'll take what we can get. So this definitely seems like the Oasis, but without the Oasis. Which is a shame, I actually like the Oasis a lot. But we'll enjoy the desert sands all we can. There's a shard. Well, there's one of three. Up, oh, there's number two. There's number three. Probably to the left somewhere. Saw that one already. Oh, it's back behind me. Tricky, tricky. Alright. Let's climb up here. We'll find all these shards, because we need them for our, expedition next door in the Forbidden Oasis, but that's not going to be my main priority. Don't really have a main priority, actually. Okay, we can do another one of these energizing things. That's pretty cool. I do have a new staff as well. Well, not a new staff, an old staff. It was Solus's, but we upgraded it, and it turned out it's actually better than the one I was using. So I have his, he has mine, and the other two... I don't know where Solus went. There he is. See, he's got my staff. Ooh, Lazarite, that looks shiny. And the other two mages have brand new staves I made for them, which are pretty good, actually. This could be a tier 3. Probably not, though. Can we climb up here? Maybe? Looks like we can, but it doesn't mean we actually can. Knowing Bioware. Is that really it? We made that bridge just for some Lazarite? Come on, there's gotta be a way up here. Come on, now! Sometimes I hate this game. Spirit calmed, unlock the door. What door? Alright, that's that thing. That's where we came in. Well, I was gonna go up here, but this might be just the world map exit then. And I'm sliding down. We are going nowhere fast. Pretty sure this is gonna say to world map. It is. Okay. Alright. Okay. Let's go close this rift while we're here, I guess. So there's a bit of an oasis around our camp. I guess that's why we made camp here. Level 11, yes. This is why I wanted to come here first. It's a lower level area. So I figured we could do it. Oh, now I have a cold staff. That's a change of pace. Kind of nice, though. Get some synergy with my fire moves. Oh, I missed myself there. There's not much of a point dispelling them because they lose health so quickly. It's not really worth the mana cost. A couple of auto attacks would do the exact same thing. Alright, let's close this fade rift. Aw, Cole has no hat. He looks strange without his hat. Build iteration. Could use some more purple rings, but I guess we'll find those as we go on. We did find one already, it's just that buggy one that, make sure your companions stop following you because you're in stealth. Why are we in combat? Something around here? I see a red dot. Oh, a hyena. Sneaky. Not so sneaky anymore. Alright. Oh, and he has friends. Great. Hyenas always remind me of the hyenas in The Lion King. Did we get it? I think we got it. Alright, so even though Varric isn't here to see it, we'll destroy the Lyrium for him if we come across it, because I really don't want to come back through here towing him along just to get the Lyrium.
None of this should be here.
And yet it is. What, these wagons? Is this what they call corralling the wagons? So there's red lyrium up there somewhere, but can't get to it from here. I do like how there's like a mystery to this region. Like, why are people here? What's going on? It's not just, here's a region, explore it. It kind of gives the region a main quest, even if there isn't exactly a main quest. Or there could be. Sandrock Mire. Let me guess, another place I can't climb up, even though it looks like I can. I'm trying to go around there, but I feel like I'm gonna get stuck then and have to go all the way back down again. No. Yep, okay, well, see, there's not even anything here. Like, why did I jump over here? There is nothing here. Alright, well, can we climb back up here at least? Or are we just have to go down to get up? Alright, there we go. So nothing over that way, turns out. There is... Is that a shard or is that... No, it's red lyrium. How do we get up here, though? Oh, come on, so close. There's gotta be a way up somewhere. I feel like that's it, right there. But where there's one way, there's probably several. So there's a quest up ahead in the cave. Research supplies. Aid the study of dragons. Property of Frederick of Sarolt, University of Orlais.
Someone is missing a teapot, papers, and little biscuits.
What happened here?
A long road, stumbling through the rocks, struck from behind.
So there's a mine here as well. So that's where the red lyrium is, that makes sense. Maybe this is where the red lyrium, the Templars are getting the red lyrium from? It's not the same thing as Venatori, but oh, Ghoul's beard. Nice. But they are on the same side. Actually, I guess Corypheus does have the Venatori on his side. They're not really an army, but they are quite powerful. It is kind of like the, it's almost like he's playing Origins, where he has the mages following him and some Templars following him. Doesn't seem like he has any elves or dwarves yet, but we'll keep an eye out. Some loot. Silver earrings. Mosaic piece. We've still yet to complete. Alright, S says the Templars, get the Templars whatever they want. No questions asked, so stop asking. They want refugees and travelers, we get them. So it sounds like they want slaves, either for a blood ritual, or to build something, or for some kind of magic. Is S, who is that guy that we saw in the note when we first got here? Was his name S? Or is S Samson, perhaps? Sounds like S is a Venatori leader, though. But that does establish the link that I was... Whoops. Meant to do that. That does establish the link that I was talking about before. The Templars and the Venatori helping one another. To our detriment. How do we get in here? And more importantly, how do we get to that other source of red lyrium? So it came in that way. Well, there is the other cave, I guess. So we're actually down south now, okay. Cervus, that's who it is. So that's kind of like the main quest there. So was that a dead end? I hope that was a dead end, because... I didn't really explore the entire thing. Ghoul's beard. So here's a cave. Can we go into this cave? Or not yet? Yep. It's definitely a cave. It has a cave icon. It looks like a cave. But it's all boarded up. It's like maybe it's the way out of a cave, but not the way in. Should I go back into the cave? Did I miss something? I feel like I missed something. Another hyena.
You can't hurt me.
I do like how your stabs glow with whatever type of rune you have on them. That's kind of cool. And another one. Thought there was some loot over there. Another quest up ahead. The Chantry uses these symbols long ago to mark trails to hidden locations. Huh.
A Chantry symbol out here. Odd.
See, there is... See, we definitely came this way, but how do we get over the ridge, I guess, is my question. Doesn't seem like we can just go up and over. Like the wall here is too steep. Slightly, but too steep. We can keep going south, I guess. Should I go back in the cave and see what's in the cave? I don't know. Let's keep going this way and see what we can find. What is this thing? Oh, a quarry! Yay! Sweet. We need one more quarry for the tower, but we have enough for the other one. Here's another cave, or a little cave. Our Lady of the Enderfells. Got some Codex XP for that. Just a giant wheel. It is another beautiful landscape, I'll give him that. There's a river down there. Like the Colorado, dutifully carving the Grand Canyon. So where, Sam, all is like, the map seems like this is cliff, this is open area, but it's almost like it's inverted. Like, this is actually the way. The cliffs are all up there. I guess there's a path over here. Lots of question marks over that direction, so. 5 of 25. Pretty sure that one guy who is delirious reporting the High Dragon is actually not so delirious. Because this seems like the place they'd want to put, like, a sand-based High Dragon. Which could be really cool. Who are these guys? They're enemies. Maybe they have a hint? White Claw Raiders. I feel like we fought them before. Maybe not in this game. But if not in this game, perhaps in the last game, or even the first game, or in Amaranthine. It sounds very familiar. It also might just be a Bioware, like, it sounds like one of their mercenary bands. The White Claw! What's over here? So it's definitely not the place to go if I wanted more elf fruit, but we'll find that sooner or later. Might as well enjoy these different ingredients while we can get them. Caravan of refugees. Drove off road so we could collect out of view of Imperial soldiers. Half died, but you can pick up the wounded. So it seems like the White Claw is definitely working to hire... What is this? Anything? No. To pick up, like, slaves for the Tevinters. Ooh, that looks cool. There's a fortress over there. There are those statues again. And I see an ocularum down there. And a good site for a camp. Let's go to the camp first. Honestly, this is one of my favorite parts of this game, I think, is exploring a new area for the first time. Where you have, like, no lay of the land. You have no idea what's going on. But everything is new and beautiful and exciting. And you're setting up your camps to kind of get your bearings. Because eventually you start, like, going in circles and trying to find the places you missed. And then it gets a little tedious. And there's another portal to close down, another rift.
Inquisitor.
Hi. Okay, so there's a... What's this quest? Draconology. Oh, so his camp is somewhere around here. He can return his notes and his pot or whatever too. There's a cool statue we can claim. Griffin Wing Monument. Oh, it's to the, oh, to the Griffins that used to be ridden by the Grey Wardens in war victory, in peace vigilance, and death sacrifice. That's actually my desk, well, one of my desktops on my tiny little monitor I have beside me, where I keep, like...
Visitors, thank the Maker.
Oh, it must be him.
It's been so long since I've spoken to anyone.
The monitor where I have Audacity right now.
The wildlife too?
I think I found your supplies. A dead man out in the desert had these on him.
Dead? Blessed Andraste. What about Marcus or Jeannette? This is terrible news. I am Frederic of Serou, foremost researcher of draconology in Orlais.
I came definitely here dragons here then.
From the university. But the others are all missing, and our work has been halted. White Claw raiders made off with much of our supplies. You will help me reclaim the equipment, will you not? You will champion the advancement of science.
Sure. If it's for science.
You're a scholar. What can you tell me about this region?
The Western Approach is a remarkable place, as you are no doubt aware. Many magnificent creatures make their home here. Vargasts, dragons, phoenixes.
Ooh, phoenixes.
They thrive where few others can. The land was poisoned by the Second Blight. The Warden Fortress has stood since that time.
Interesting.
Before the Blight, the ancient Imperium ruled.
That explains the Griffins
actually,
over there.
I saw some Tevinters recently. Studying the runes, perhaps.
Yeah, I don't think they are.
The rest of your team went missing, and there are raiders all over the area. Should you be here alone?
I don't know what happened to the rest of the expedition, but the raiders have left me completely undisturbed. I've also seen Grey Wardens and strangers in odd
really?
Clothing. but they all ignore my presence.
Completely. Living Grey Wardens. That's interesting.
Tell me about yourself.
I am a professor at the University of Orléans. I have made it my life's work to write the definitive monograph on the hunting habits of dragons and their closest kin. On this trip alone, I have produced 20 scrolls of notes. More scholarship than has ever been done on the Southern Vargest. But my hope, my great ambition, is to observe the abyssal high dragon taking her prey.
Abyssal high dragon, okay.
No scholar has ever recorded.
Hopefully he has some notes that could help me. It'd be cool if, like, if you helped with this quest, he would tell you, like, what the weakness of the dragon is, or, like, a good strategy against it. Because there's going to be mechanics, as there always are.
I have the supplies you were waiting for right here. But,
yeah, it's only some.
Some of our equipment is still missing.
I saw that quest pop up.
If you happen to find more of it, please let me know.
Will do.
We'll have to speak some other time.
Always recognize Riordan's voice when I hear it.
Be completely ignored by the bandits and the
it is strange. Are they hoping he completes his research and then they're going to steal it? I don't know if they really have an interest in dragon research. So I'm less interested in his Vargas or whatever than I am. Oh, here's a chantry thing.
The trail leads on.
Than I am in the high dragon. But then again, I do want to fight whatever those other creatures were he mentioned. Okay, so there's the trail. More lyrium over there. Our quick bar's getting pretty filled up, actually. We might have to start being careful with what abilities we take. They really should have given you more than 8. Even if you have to click on some of them, like, at least give us a choice to have more than 8. Because, like, if I get revive and click on it, did I do it? I guess I got it. Alright, let's make this our main quest for now. So I don't lose the trail. Seems like there are rain clouds ahead, oddly. This of all places. Although maybe it's not lack of water that makes this a desert, maybe it's the Blight. Since apparently these lands were affected during the Second Blight. So there's a lot of history and lore to this zone, which I kind of like. And a Grey Warden fortress somewhere, that'll be cool to explore. Maybe even living Grey Wardens. Although that quest remains to be seen.
The end must be nearby.
So like I said, this is actually part of the main quest. It's just a minor branch, I think. I think the Warden one is actually our current, like, main branch. Although you can do it before or after the Winter Palace. So there's some kind of magical cave down there. Is that where I'm going? Hyenas? Oh, a phoenix. Not what I was expecting. Not too tough either. Then again, I am 5 levels over it, so it's not really a sporting challenge, but it just is what it is. Kind of thought they'd be a little... Oh, some bloodstone. A little more like the Harry Potter phoenix, I guess, but... Those wouldn't make as good of adversaries as that kind of thing does. Alright, let's use some, well, what the hell. It's level 10, so I'm just going to use fire magic to overpower it. I kind of like that, though. It makes sense that if you were a powerful enough mage, you could defeat any type of barrier with any type of magic. It's just easier if you have the corresponding element. Or the opposite of the corresponding element. The creation of a phylactery. We let the boy rest the first night they brought him to the white spot. Oh, I don't want to read all this. I'm not sure the creation of a phylactery is a big mystery. The creation of a tranquil is. Although I think we know a little bit about that because of Finrail. We cannot confirm that Faramond has any luck attracting spirits at all. It may not be possible for spirits in the Fade to even see someone who has so long been tranquil. He wishes to continue the experiments. We will stay in obscure until he is ready to leave. Alright, so there is... Speaking of the tranquil, apparently the Chantry had a tranquil here to do some kind of experiment. Templar Commander armor. human trained warrior, so not Iron Bull. See, at first I didn't like it at all when they had the whole human trained, Quinari trained, whatever, but because they actually do have elven trained armor, that kind of. I'm still not the biggest fan of it, I don't think, but if they're going to do separate, at least they're doing separate but equal, I guess, where even though we can't share armors. I guess that was the Chantry Cache, right? Yeah. Oop, I see some white claws. Level 15, okay, so they do scale. I'm glad of that. Otherwise this would get pretty boring. See, even at level they're pretty easy. But that's my own fault for putting it on normal mode.
Frederick ordered a tea kettle, and it never arrived.
How sad. 4 or 5, thank you. About to say, it didn't go up. So I guess they stole his supplies. More ring velvet. See, part of me feels like we should have waited a little longer to wait a little more, few more supplies to do all that crafting, but can't wait too long. It just keeps staring at me, it had to go. If you wait too long, then the stuff is kind of useless. Leave the wardens to their work, concentrate efforts on the dragon, Cerevis. So Cerevis is fighting the dragon as well. But to what end? You have to be crazy or adventurous to fight a dragon. I need to find a merchant too. 66, okay, we're okay for now. Anything else here? Guess not. So they must need the dragon's blood or something from it. See, there's something else in this cave. It's just the... No, it's not the banner. I feel like I missed something. This is not in the cave. Maybe it's above the cave. Nope, we got everything in here. Alright, so whatever I'm seeing on my radar, for lack of a better term, seems to be outside of the cave. All this is probably just a crafting node. What's that? That doesn't look too good. Let's not step in there. Some lazurite. Deep mushroom. More lazurite. No wonder they call this place the Wastes. Quite a wasteland indeed. Even the air around here looks toxic. I wouldn't want to breathe it. Aha! It was lazurite. Or something. What is it? Can I click on it? It's not letting me harvest whatever that is, but okay. Paragon's Luster. Apparently. Alright, grab this one over here. Yep, can't grab this guy. Alright, should we head down to the waste? Can we head down to the waste? Probably not. Oh, this is one of Vivian's quests over here. Well, she's not here. We can probably do it anyway. See, my first thought is I'm probably going to insta-die if I go down there. My second thought is it might summon a high dragon, but my money is on insta-die, so let's quick save and give it a shot. Yep, insta-die. Oh, now I'm low on health. Yeah, whatever. Alright, so enough exploring this little area here. I guess we can choose a direction and start running. Let's see what we find. What's up here? See some bad guys. I think they're bad guys. They are bad guys. some more White Claw Raiders. A bit of lag there. Loot their bodies. We have plenty of research supplies. We do have to return those. Something else here or no? Where was his camp? Wasn't that far away. Let's activate the quest. This is the Western Approach. Frederick, there we go. Alright, so he is over this way. I hear something. Is that a dragon? I don't see anything. Alright, let's head over this way. Shimmerstone Mire. A book over here. Which, oh, it's okay. One of those things for Vivian. So if she's not here, we have to give it to her when we get back. We can do that.
This is big. Doesn't look like Vince built it. Who's out here?
Alright, so we should explore this place, but I really want to turn in his research before we get too far off the beaten trail. More minerals. Ah, red lyrium under there somewhere. We'll get to that in a bit. Okay. This camp is somewhere down here. I think that's it. Yep, there he is. Let's see if he gives us anything in return.
It seems very unlikely that she could be nesting at this time of year. Ah, fellow researcher, how can I help you?
Sorry.
Return whenever you like. I'm always glad of the company of a fellow scholar. After more than 30 days, I have yet to observe the abyssal high dragon in... Oh, yes?
Probably lucky, then.
Can I assist you?
I have the supplies you were waiting for right here.
Now that I have my recipes back, I'll be able to concoct a bait the High Dragon cannot resist.
A bait?
I have most of what I need, but I still need to gather quillback intestines and a phoenix's tail feather.
So the dragon eats phoenixes and quillbacks, apparently.
You study dragons. I'd be interested in hearing more about that.
Oh, they are fascinating and little understood creatures, thought extinct for centuries. Now they seem to be making a comeback.
It is the Dragon Age.
The Nivarans wrote extensively on breeding and nesting behavior, but high dragon hunting patterns have never been studied. I would be
probably for good reason.
If you come across any Gurn corpses that might be victims of dragon attacks,
I will keep an eye out.
We'll have to speak some other time.
Yep, okay, so we have two new quests. Lots of stuff going on around here. Alright, let's head to that cave first. See what's in there. And then we'll probably end this episode after that. Before it gets to be too long. Yep, there's the mine. Or is that the red lyrium right there? Oh, it's right here. Okay. Come on, Iron Bull. There we go. That was easy. can still go down here though. Oh, another quarry. Perfect. Yay. So now we have everything we need to upgrade the tower. We have to do that when we get back to a camp. Some nice loot. Is that... I guess that's it for the mine. Can't go down there. Alright. Well, we did find a quarry, though. That makes me happy. Oh, and we also found some more White Claw members. There we go. Yeah, I still wouldn't mind having, even though the mana replenishes very quickly, I'd like to have a nice big mana pool because then I could use barrier. Whoops. Oh, where'd you come from? And fire mine and my pull of the abyss. All in quick succession. Alright, kill him for good. There we go. Guess it's everybody here. Alright, so... Ocularum over there. Camp up there. Alright, well, I'm going to end the episode here. What I'm probably going to do now... Whoops, didn't mean to do that. Is go back to the camp to just to craft that thing real quick, and then quick travel to a merchant somewhere, sell off a bunch of the junk that I have in my inventory, and then come back to the camp before the next episode. So, thank you guys for watching, and I will be right back.